Structural elements, pillars or columns. They are elongated and vertical elements. They form part of the structural framework and are subjected to compression. When they are slim, they can suffer from buckling. Beams, joists, and lintels. They are elongated horizontal elements and work with flexion. The beams are supported by two columns or load-bearing walls. The joists are typically supported between two beams and allow for the construction of the floor. The lintel forms part of the massive structure and is utilized to open door and window openings. Footings. They are large concrete blocks in contact with the ground and connected to columns. They are subjected to compression and bending. Its function is to diminish the forces that the structure transmits to the ground. Piles. They are large columns that are buried in clay-like or unstable ground to reach a firmer ground on which to support the structure. Load-bearing walls. They are wide and long massive elements with relatively little thickness. There are two types. Load-bearing walls support vertical forces, compression. Containment walls support horizontal forces, bending and tipping. Arches. Arches are formed by pieces called voussaires and a central piece called a keystone. The pieces in contact with the columns are called springers. All of them work in compression. They transmit the forces of the pillars and tend to dump them. The pillars that hold the arches may need a buttress. Braces. They are steel cables that serve to reinforce the structure or to keep it in balance. They are always subjected to traction forces, and they offer no resistance to compression. If they have a device that allows them to modify their length and adjust the tension of the cables, they are called tensioners. Struts. They are steel bars that reinforce structures by triangulation. They can be subjected to traction or compression. Brackets. They are triangular reinforcement elements at the joint points of the structural pieces, and they are subject to compression.